day I ran over John Williams. The brakes on my bike weren't at all sound. I would slow down just by dragging my shoes on the ground, nicely warming up my toes, though. It was a crisp spring day as I cycled along. White, fluffy clouds accompanied me as I journeyed on, over Hammersmith Flyover, Cromwell Road, then forked right, now in sight of Earlscourt Station pedestrian traffic lights. I could see they were just changing from green to red. I needed to get ahead. I pushed my pedals madly round, no intention of slowing down. I recognised him in a flash. It was John Williams, the classical guitarist. He jumped right out in front of me. There was no way I could stop. The impact threw his guitar case high into the sky with a musical pop. It landed in the road with a mournful sigh. Was it an E minor 11th or a D minor 4th? I should worry. It was all my fault. I'd nearly robbed the world of the greatest classical guitarist of all time, and now I was regretting not finishing my music theory exam, which I should have taken in 2009. As I shuddered to a halt, an angry crowd began to taunt. "You've gone and run over a classical guitar musical giant. No more Bach prelude. You're a cycling tyrant." The guitar chord now gave way to the sound of sirens of an ambulance and a police van. As I turned round, I could see John Williams with his head in his hands, his priceless Jose Ramirez classical guitar in case had paid the full price for my poor brakes. He came towards me. He formed his hands into fists. I shouted out, "John, I'm really sorry. I promised to get my brakes fixed. I'll get you some glue and sort out your guitar. No harm done, really, though it's all a bit bizarre. And yes, I did jump the lights. I promise that's the last time I'll give anyone a bicycle fright, all right?" "You don't want to be the one who runs over Mr. and Mrs. Henry Ford or Ollie Ricks. No. So drive carefully. Always stop at red lights and make sure you get your brakes fixed."